Lance,
mention
po ba kayo? Meron po ba kayong anything that you'd like to start with?
Well, about the Las Piñas Pogo incident, no? We have agreed with the police that custody of these people, the foreigners, will be technically under the Bureau of Immigration, legally under the Bureau of Immigration, although they'll be kept in the Las Piñas quarters in the site of the Pogo where they were raided, because we do not have the facilities in BI to keep them. So, but they're under the legal custody of the Bureau of Immigration. That will clarify a lot of issues about the habeas corpus petitions being filed, because they're being held for cause by the Bureau of Immigration. And we must remember that the rights of persons to enter your country is always subject to the conditions set forth in the visas issued to them. And visas are conditionally privileged documents given by the state to allow you entry into the country, into our country.
Sir, do you know how many are you talking about? Do you have an exact number?
It must be still in the 1,000, in the 1,000 mark. But we expect this to ease up later on, because the embassies have been coordinating with us about the deportation or the repatriation of many of them. But one of the things that we are now asking the BI is also to blacklist them, because they were found being involved in an illegal activity. Then we must blacklist them for violating the provisions of their stay in the country.
Sir, clarification. Will all of them be get deported or
repatriated or deported? That will depend. But we want the repatriations to be with condition that they will be blacklisted, because if they were engaged in any illegal activity, then we should not admit them back into the country.
Sir, maybe ask for the legal basis for the continued detention if they're not considered.
Violation of conditions of the visa is enough for the Bureau of Immigration to hold them indefinitely under custody.
How do you classify or how do you categorize or characterize their stay? Is it preventive custody?
It's legal custody, because they're under investigation for the violation of their visas, for the conditions of their visas. Because the presumption is, if they have working visas, they're here legally to work in a lawful activity. If the activity is unlawful, then it's already a violation of the visa issued. And the licenses were cancelled by the PAGCOR already. The licenses of these POGOs were cancelled by PAGCOR, which gives rise also to the fact that their stay is already illegal.
Sir, ano po yung nationalities ng mga
ito? Lahat eh, maraming nationalities. Meron pa Singaporean, di ba? There are 17 nationalities recorded among those who were caught in Las Piñas.
There were reports nagkakagulo sa loob, but ang sinasabi reason is nag-aagawan ng provisions. Is there any truth to this?
No. Provisions, we have asked PAGCOR to help us carry through the food and other necessities for these people, because PAGCOR is the government entity that allowed them in before. They have held themselves accountable also to the government by giving us the assistance needed to for the sustenance of these people while they are being processed and deported.
Sending a person this morning, the PNP said there's one more Chinese fugitive that was discovered from that facility, reaching a total of eight. Are they part of the five respondents or
I'm not sure about the details. But the problem kasi nga is the validation of the identities of these people.
does not take immediate leave. If they have no passports or we do not have a copy of their passports, we are not able to validate the identity immediately. So we rely on, we depend on the embassies to help us identify these people properly.
So in the case of fugitives, will they be immediately deported, unlike the others who have existing?
We will have to follow the law on deportation. We will have to clear their records. If there are cases pending against them, we will have to have them dismissed so that we can deport them accordingly. Oh, meron pa? Ano? Iba naman? Sige, iba naman. Oh.
Sige, ikaw muna. Go.
Sir, yung meron ba? Wala po sila, sir, naging asawa ng Pilipino?
Kung may asawa, baka ang habeas corpus might lie. As in our experience in Pampanga, yung mga asawa ng Pilipino na bibigyan ng pagkakataon sa habeas corpus magpaliwanag. Pero yung mga wala, siyempre, ano na yan eh, violation of visa na yan.
Other topic, sir. Sir, this afternoon, pagpapatuloy po nung Degamo preliminary investigation, expected na magpapayo na po ng kanilang counter-affidavits yung mga respondents. Si Congressman Tevez, wala pa rin po sa bansa, I understand, sir. Anong ine-expect niyo po na mangyayari if hindi po siya
mag-file? Nasa NPS na po yan, nasa National Prosecution Service na po yan, na kumilos tungkol sa bagay na yan. We do not micromanage the NPS. We allow them all the leeway necessary for them to do their jobs. And it is their, it's a specialized job that they have. And we believe that they will be able to look at this with equanimity and justice.
But usually, sir, kapag isa pong respondent hindi po nag-file ng counter-affidavit, ano po yung nangyayari?
Pag hindi nag-file ng counter-affidavit, well, there can be findings also because if the person is a fugitive from justice, obviously there's information that he has skipped the country, obviously that he does not want to fall under a jurisdiction. Well, it's for them to rule on this. But there are matters of fact that are taken into consideration by those who are supposed to rule on the matter.
Sir, other topic. The Supreme Court released a ruling yesterday, actually it was March 5, but the topic is about yesterday, regarding former Palawan Governor Mario Joel Reyes. It ordered the Palawan Court to issue an arrest warrant. First, said, the fact that the Supreme Court affirmed the power of the Justice Secretary to create a second prosecution panel, your reaction to that? And secondly, the fact that he is reported to be arrested again, what steps are the authorities taking?
Well, that's how the law works. And the Supreme Court recognizes the power of the executive over the prosecution of persons. And the Secretary of Justice is the one that may carry out all of the necessary actions to be able to ensure the successful prosecution of people who have violated the law or have been charged accordingly in court. And we thank the Supreme Court for the confidence that they give the Secretary of Justice and the Department of Justice in this matter. And ano na yan eh? Prosecution is a matter of, it's a matter that has to be done for those who have violated the law. And the Supreme Court is correct in that matter. And we're just waiting for these things to fall into place again and that the arrest warrants have to be properly served for them to be able to be under the jurisdiction of the court again.
Do you have any idea now, sir, if Mr. Reyes, former Governor Reyes, is still in the matter?
I have no idea, but we can find out. I don't know. I am not sure about that. But that must be in place if there is no final dismissal of their case. By the way, the Degamo suspects have been transferred already to the BJMP in Bicutan so that, ano ba yan? Taguig court ba sila? O Manila court?
Manila court.
But the BJMP are ready to custody of them.
Sec.
Manila City Jail.
Sec. Kamusta yung palang extension?
Yeah, Manila City Jail.
Sir, kumusta yung ano, nakapagsabita po ba ng original copies of recommendations ng ilang mga actors? And kung hanggang sa PA po nga, hindi sila nakapagsabit, ano naman yung implications nito sa medical resolution na
ba? Well, ano nga yan eh. Frowned upon naman ang recantation. We do not have to take every recantation as gospel truth. Because the previous statements, given the totality of all the statements involved and the totality of all the facts, is taken into consideration by the prosecution in weighing all of these statements. So it does not change anything, if at all, because recantations, as I always said, are looked upon with disfavor by the courts and even by the prosecution, because we know that it is human experience which tells us that recantations are an afterthought after looking at the responsibility attached to what they had done. They do not want to admit it anymore.
Sir, may sagot mo ba yung IDP doon sa sulat natin
ng NSA? Hindi pa. Hindi ko pa na-follow up sa IBP, but we will follow up. There will be another meeting of the Anti-Terror Council, which I will attend very soon.
Sir, doon po sa...
After the soda.
Other evidence po na nakalap pa ng NBI na magpapalakas po doon sa kaso, meron...
Marami kami ibang independent evidence. Don't worry, you'll find out later on when all of these are presented in court. We do not want to preempt these facts. We do not want to let everything out at once. We have to keep some of them as part of our legal strategy.
Sir, follow-up to the UK Governor Reyes. The first time around, he was cleared by the prosecution panel. Then there was another panel which included him, citing the telephone conversation with one of the alleged panelists. Is the DOJ inclined to bring a third panel or a police?
We'll see. If necessary, we will. Okay.
May additional arrested by the PNP. I think there were three.
In Cavite. Two of them were arrested in Cavite.
Yes. There were also surrenders.
Yes.
Is this with respect to the first case? And whose status?
I'm sorry, I'm not familiar with the details of the cases, but I just know from what I've been told that there were two more arrests made in Cavite, and that all of these suspects are now being are vetted accordingly. Para there is criminal responsibility attached to their acts will be made account. They will be made accountable for them. Ano yan eh? It's a political process already that happened. We are no longer members of the ICC, so my concern is not too much on the ICC. We follow the principle of committee by appealing to them not to interfere with our legal system. And the same thing will still hold now. Ayaw po natin na may mga ibang bansa na nakikialam sa sistema ng justisya sa Republika ng Pilipinas. Hindi po tayo kolonya, hindi po tayo teritoryo ng ibang bansa na nais makialam sa atin. At marami po rito ay sakop rin po ng laro ng politika na naroroon po sa ating buong mundo ngayon. May kanya-kanya pong kampo ang politika na pinaninindigan ng maraming tao. At isa na po yan sa mga dahilan na nakikita namin sa ICC na meron pong political agenda ang mga taong nais makialam sa kalayaan ng Republika ng Pilipinas at sa ating sovereignty.
Sobrenya, no?
Sir, by your position, do you think it was a mistake for the Philippines to function on the Rome Statute in the first place if there is that danger of political interference?
We always do everything in good faith, but actually good faith is not enough. Because pag nakita mo na kasi ang leanings ng politics, ang international politics, whether kung liberal yan o conservative, nagbabago-bago ang hihip ng hangin. Marahil nagkamali tayo, marahil hindi. Pero ang tingin ko kasi, ang ICC, yan po ay dapat gumagana sa mga bansang walang sistema ng hustisya. Yung mga magugulong bansa na nagkakagulo, gaya ng Sudan sa ngayon, yung mga nagkakagulo sa, sabihin natin sa iba't ibang parte ng mundo, kung saan walang batas na umiiral, dyan po kinakailangan ng ICC. Sa katulad po natin, na meron po tayong law enforcement, meron tayong prosecution, meron tayong korte, meron tayong legal tradition, ay kaya na ho natin panagutan ang sarili nating bansa. Ang ICC po ay para sa mga bansang walang sistema ng batas na umiiral at doon po talaga kinakailangan yan. Hindi ho para makialam sila sa isang establishing sistema katulad ng Republika ng Pilipinas. Hindi sila welcome sa Pilipinas. Tayo po ay very hospitable people. Kaya lang, pagka pakikialam na ang gagawin nila, ay hindi po tayo papayag sapagkat may sarili po tayong sistema ng batas, may sarili tayong tradisyon, may sarili tayong kapulisan, may sarili tayong prosecution, meron tayong korte na hindi nila pwedeng pakialaman o kaya maliwalain. Iyan po ay igalang nila ang ating sovereignty, ang aking pakiusap sa kanila at wag nilang susubukang makialam sa atin dito.
Sir, about the possibility of certain individuals being indicted?
Politika yan. It's going to be a political, in the end, ang gana niyan ay politika. Katulad ng paglapit ng mga CPP-NPA sa United Nations nung araw, pinupolitika nila, ganun din yan. Naghaharap sila ng international forum para idulog yung kanilang politika kasapagkat hindi nila maidulog dito sa ating bansa. Ang sinasabi ko naman, basta't mayroong ebidensya na nakaturo sa mga taong nais nilang usigin natin, ay ibigay sa atin ang ebidensya at tayo na hong bahala na habulin ang mga taong nag-gumawa ng mga krimen sa ating bansa.
So sir, if in the event we will issue an arrest warrant, the Philippine government will not comply to those
rules? Hindi, wala silang gagawin dito eh. Wala silang kinalaman sa atin dito. At anong gagawin nila? Papasukin nila tayo? Gusto ba nilang pasukin tayo na bilang isang kolonya na naman? Eh, tapos na yun eh. Ginawa na tayong kolonya dati ng Espanya, ginawa na tayong kolonya ng Amerika, ginawa na tayong kolonya ng Japan nung araw, pero tama na. Eh, malaya tayong bansa na may sariling sistema ng batas.
Okay.
Sir, baka may iahabol ka.
Wala pa, wala. Malapit siya.
Ay, wait. Sorry, sir. Ito, habol. Sir, bantay update.
Ayun na. Basta't hinahabol pa rin siya. Hinahanap, hinahabol, at kukunin. Kukunin natin siya. Pananagutin natin siya sa krimen na nakapataw sa kanyang pangalan. At sana ay magunos-dili siya at sumuko na lang upang maging malinaw ang sistema ng hustisya. Salamat po!